Hi everyone, Sildy here. In this video, we're going to talk about how you can get the butcher pet in the Diagonal Twisting. Then I'm going to show you a quick way that you can get this pet in less than 10 minutes. So of course, as the achievement states, you want to get the achievement in Eerie Red Glow Blush Your Vision. So it requires killing the Dark Lord in a solo game starting with a level 1 character. Now the tips and tricks in this video will be catered to returning players as well as people who already have played the season for a while and have some Paragon and some gear. So this video will be for everyone. So of course, if you are a returning player, first thing you got to do, use all your Paragon. There's no reason why not to have it. It's just more damage, it's more toughness, and it's just going to be a lot quicker for you. And of course, if you have a lot of Paragon like me, get a little bit of Vitality as well like that, and then just do it in main stat. Now, another quick thing we want to do is just quickly, we want to make a Indium, trying to get an ancient one, but if you don't have one, that's fine either way. And then you want a Gem of Ease. So Gem of Ease is this gem here. So basically, it allows you to put it on a level 1 weapon. And as long as it's level 25, this is fine. So we want to use our Gem of Ease, put it into our level 70 Indium, and then put that on. As you can see, we now have a ton of damage, even for a level 1 character, which is really nice. Now, another thing we can do is have a Hellfire Ring and a Hellfire Amulet. And in this Hellfire Amulet, I have a socket, so I also have my Legacy of Dreams. But you shouldn't actually need the two of these. It's just more damage. The weapon alone should be more than enough to carry you through this. But if you have them, why not use it? And of course, get the LOD and a socket. And then the last stage is the Kanai's Cube. Now, this can actually help you quite a lot. So, for instance, for the weapon, for if playing Monk, I would actually recommend the Messerschmitt Reaver. This is going to allow you to get a lot more dashes, and then you can get through the maps even quicker. And then for the armor slot, of course, the most important item for the Monk is the Kudus Boots. By the way, if you're a returning player and you also want to use this kind of strategy, you can also just go and do the challenge rift real quick. It resets every Monday, and then you can gamble blood shards on a level 1 character, and then you can also get the Kudus Boots. Just this item should be enough even for a returning player without anything else. And for Judas slot, something like the Obsidian Rift of the Zodiac would be a nice help as well. I don't have it, I didn't even run with it, but if you have it, go for it. So now we're all set up, we have our layout equipped, we have our cube ready, and now we can go and blast. Now I'm going to show you a quick way to get to Diablo, who is on the 16th level, i.e. the last level in the entire Diagonal Twisting event. So basically, I'm going to tell you how not to get lost, because it can be kind of confusing and there's a lot of bosses and stuff that we don't want to kill. So of course, we start with going to Act 1 and going to the Old Ruins where the event is held. We then want to run down here past the water fountain, and there's a portal right here. Go into that portal, and then you just want to hit straight up. Just keep going until you find this Labyrinth level 1 place and just go in. And of course, since we are playing without Gem of Ease, we're getting a ton of levels early on. This is basically just going to allow us to get our water allies really quickly, and then we can of course use those for a much easier and smoother experience. And as you can see, our Mystic Allies require level 22, so get to level 22 and then just equip those when you can. So we're just going to keep heading down, and here we already have the first level. It's straight away from the start. Make sure to also get some passive, something like Fleet Footer to give you more movement speed, and then just head further on. After level 2, you want to go upwards and to the west, like here. Make sure of course to always get new spells and new passive, just to make it a bit easier. Now go past these two doors, you can't just go and kill the boss. But right past them, you have the Labyrinth level 3 here. Now, the good thing is we are playing with Indium and Mr. Smith, so we have a ton of cooldown reduction, which should allow us to get a ton of dashes in. Therefore, we can get around a lot quicker. Now, when you are in level 3, do not go here and go into King Lorik's tomb. That is a waste of time. It's not in there. You want to go down instead. That's where level 4 is. And as you can see, we're just dashing through this entire level 4 map. Oh, I actually found a guy there that's going to prog my Indium again. So we can just keep dashing on this. Get around super quickly. So we're already at level 5 after 4 minutes, and it's just gonna go a lot easier and smoother after this as well, of course. Now from level 5 to level 6, so we just got here, you want to go down and to the right. And of course, as before, make sure to skip these places if they're not a Labyrinth level and it's just a boss. We're just gonna skip it for now. This is not what we're after. Now the most important thing here in level 7, do not go into this area up here called Halls of the Blind. This is a dead end, so if you see this, just turn around. As long as you skip that part about Vert the Dark, it's actually really easy, and just keep moving forward, and it should be just around the corner. You get to level 9, and level 10 is just around the corner here. Very easy, super smooth. And honestly, these levels here from about level 8 to level 12 take like 30 seconds per level, so it's super easy to get through these as well. And from here into level 15 is actually super quick. You just want to keep going forward. Can't really go wrong, and even if you do, you do have Mr. Smith and Indium for even more movement speed. Now this is where it actually gets a bit messy. So on level 15, there won't be a one called level 16, but what you need to do is go into the Unholy Altar. And as you can see up here, these doors are locked. There's nothing. It doesn't really show that you can go any further, but all you got to do is go to the edges of the map. So over here, for instance, and then click this book here. You get teleported to the room, you clear out the room, and then of course you want to go to the other side down here, do the same thing, clear the room as well, and then in the middle here, there'll be a boss, kill that boss, and we then get a portal to level 16. So of course, go through that, go over here, kill the things in here, click these door switches and just go through these. There'll be another door switch over here as well. Make sure to click that one. Yep, and it's just about cleaning the rooms real quick. Killing the door switches, and there you go. He spawned, and we insta-kill him, of course. And there you have it, there's the pet. Make sure to watch the playlist here for even more Jabba guides, and I'll see you there. Peace.